Hi, I'm Sean. In this video, I will guide you on how to set up a network video recording system with Synology Surveillance Station. Surveillance Station is a network video recording system that runs on all Synology NAS devices. Its interface lets you watch live feeds from multiple IP cameras, playback recordings, batch manage device settings, and much more. There are over 4,000 IP cameras that are compatible with Synology Surveillance Station. I will provide a link in the description below with a list of all compatible IP cameras. In this tutorial, we will go through how to set up the Surveillance Station package in your Synology NAS and how to connect an IP camera. Before we start this tutorial, please make sure your IP camera has been connected to the same local area network with your Synology NAS. Now, let's get started. To set up Surveillance Station, you will first need to log into your Synology NAS and go into the Package Center. You can find Surveillance Station under the Security tab in the left panel, or you can simply type Surveillance Station in the search bar. Click Install and wait for your Synology NAS to download and install the package. Once installed, Surveillance Station can be found in the main menu. Now, let's open Surveillance Station and set up a camera. In this demonstration, we will be using an Axis M1011 IP camera. As mentioned earlier, you can refer to the description below for a list of all compatible IP cameras. In Surveillance Station, find and click on the IP camera icon which is located on the desktop. In the top left corner, click Add and then Add Camera to launch the Add Camera wizard. Let's select Complete Setup to set up our IP camera. Now, let's find your camera. Let's start by giving your camera a name. We'll use Office as an example. In the IP address field, you can manually enter your camera's IP address. Or you can hit the search icon to the right to search for all IP cameras connected to your local area network. You can also enter the name of your camera in the search bar in the upper right-hand corner if there are several cameras already connected to your network. After locating your camera, please enter your camera's username and password. You should be able to find information about the default username and password in your camera's documentation. You can hit Test Connection to verify that your camera has been successfully connected to the server. An image of your camera's view angle should appear on the right if you're successful. After your test is complete, you can hit Next. Here, we can customize the camera's video settings. On the top, you can specify which format you want your videos to be recorded in. We'll use H.264 as an example. Next is Stream Allocation. Stream Allocation allows you to customize how you view your streams on a certain device. For example, I would like the stream to my mobile device to be of lower resolution. Just select Stream 2 next to Mobile, and the settings options for Stream 2 should appear below. I can then select the resolution, FPS, bitrate, and image quality here. After you've made your settings, hit Next. Here, we can customize some recording options for the camera. On the top, you can customize how often you want your feed saved to your new file. Below, you can set a pre and post recording time for each file. Then you can set how long you want to keep each file and also set a space limit for file storage. After you've made your settings, hit Next. Here, you can customize recording schedules. The recording schedule is set to continuous recording by default. But if you would like to, for example, set motion detection only for Saturday and Sunday, just click Motion Detection above and highlight the days and times you would like. After you've made your settings, you can hit Finish. You will return to the IP camera screen and your camera should appear on the top. Now that your camera has been successfully connected, you can now operate the various network video recording features of Surveillance Station. We will go over some of these features in our upcoming videos. If you have any questions or suggestions for any future videos, please leave us a message in the comment section below. Thank you and see you next time.